you're going to have a cardiac stress perfusion MRI scan. This film will explain what the scan will involve and allow you to prepare for the test. An MRI is a magnet scanner, which takes really detailed pictures of the heart muscle without using x-rays. Stress perfusion means giving you a medicine called adenosine that makes the heart work harder, as if you were exercising, and looking at the effect on blood flow in the heart muscle. It's a technical process, so it does take quite a long time. You can expect to be in the scanner for 30 to 40 minutes and in the department for up to 2 hours. Before your scan, you'll be asked to change into a hospital gown, and the radiographers will run through a safety checklist to make sure it's safe to give you the dye and to make sure you don't have any pacemakers, metal implants or foreign bodies. This is really important for safety, and please let them know if you have any of these or if you've ever been injured by a metal foreign body such as shrapnel. The small plastic tube called a cannula will be put into a vein in each arm so we can give you dye and the adenosine medicine. Once you're in the scan room, you'll be asked to lie down on the scanner bed and you'll be asked some more safety questions. You'll have the chance to practice holding your breath before the test starts. You'll be asked to hold your breath repeatedly throughout the scan. Sticky dots will be put on your chest to monitor your heartbeat. You'll be given some headphones so you can hear the radiographers and to protect your hearing from the scanner, which can get quite noisy. The radiographers will put an MRI coil over your chest, which is a device to improve the pictures that we take. The cannulas will be connected to the contrast and to the adenosine. You'll also be given a cool bell to hold, which you can squeeze if you have any problems or concerns at any point during the scan. You'll then move into the scanner, head first, and the scanning will start. The radiographers will take the first few pictures to make sure we're scanning precisely the right area. The radiographer or consultant who's supervising the scan will then come in and give you the adenosine, just for a couple of minutes. This will make you feel like you've done some exercise. You might feel very flushed or hot, like your heart is beating very fast, or like you're a little out of breath. We'll be in the scan room with you, so please tell us when you get any symptoms, but remember this is quite normal and shows that the medicine is working. We'll then take some more pictures. The medicine will be stopped and the effects will wear off after a few seconds. After this, there will be more scans to look at the way your heart is pumping, some using a special dye, but without any more adenosine. At the end of the scan, you'll be free to go home. The results will be sent to the doctor that requested the test. For the best chance of really good pictures, it's helpful if you can do a few things to prepare before the scan. Please make sure you bring your medicines or a list of what you're taking on the day. There are some drugs that you shouldn't take before your scan, and the radiographers will contact you in the week or so before and will go through this with you. It's really important that you don't have any caffeine for at least 18 hours before the scan. This includes tea, coffee, chocolate and fizzy drinks such as cola or energy drinks. Caffeine stops the adenosine from working properly, which might give the impression that the scan is normal when in fact there might still be an underlying problem. It may be useful to practice holding your breath. Some of the breath holds are quite long, and although the radiographers won't expect you to hold your breath for the full time, the longer you can do so, the better pictures we'll get. Do drink plenty of water before the scan, but it's important that you don't eat or drink anything else for 4 hours before the scan starts. It's helpful if someone brings you to your appointment or if you use public transport. While it's usually okay to drive after the scan, it's not recommended, and we can't guarantee that you won't need medicines which could make you feel drowsy and stop you from driving. Hopefully now you have a good understanding about what the test is going to involve. If you have any further questions or worries, please get in touch with us using the number on your appointment letter, or you can ask any of the staff on the day.